we are going to learn about science subject. In our previous chapters, you already learned about surrounding. What do you mean by surrounding? The things which is around us we call as surrounding. You already learned in our previous chapters. Here, give example. What are the things you are observed in our home surrounding? Yes. Chair. Then one. Father, mother, plants, etc. These are the things we can see in our home surroundings. Okay, tell me student, which are the things you are observed in your surrounding classroom? Okay. Classroom. Then board, etc. Okay, next, in your school surrounding, which are the things you observed? Yes, field, classroom, bus, etc. These are the examples for the things which are surrounded. How can we write in this statement form? Yes? The things which around us we call as surrounding. This same definition is also called as the definition for environment. Okay, what do you mean by environment? The things which around us we call as environment. By using this beautiful environment, today we are going to learn the chapter Living World. The chapter name is Living World. In this chapter, we are going to learn about the meaning of environment, living and non-living things, and what are the characteristics of living things. First, we see the meaning of environment. Meaning of environment. Here we can see that the things which around us we call as environment. The another meaning for environment is of living and non-living organisms existed in our surroundings. We call as environment. Whatever the thing, either it is living or non-living, we call as these living and non-living things, we call as environment. Here, living. Here we can see the non-living. Here, what is living and non-living? Yes, living and non-living are the components of environment. Here, environment consists of both living and non-living components. Environment consists of both living and non-living components. We call as environment. Here living component and another one is non-living component. Environment is made up of both components, that is one is living component and another one is non-living component. Okay, now we learn the definition of environment. By using these definitions, we are going to learn about living and non-living components. Okay, students, how can we identify the given object or the object which we are observed in our surrounding is living or non-living? Here, the definition for living components are living component. Living components are living being. Both are same. Living components means the thing which grow, breathe and move, we call as living component. In similar way, non-living component. Now we are going to learn about living and non-living. See here, in this definition of living component, things which grow, breathe and move we call as living component or living organism. In the same way, non-living means things which cannot move, grow and breathe. We call as non-living component. Here I am not write can. Here we can use can or we can write things which grow, breathe and move. Here we can see that cannot. By using these living and non-living components, we can easily say the meaning of living components, meaning of non-living component, and we easily differentiate the difference between living and non-living components. Now, plant. Plants are example for living or non-living. Can you guess? Yes? Here example. Plant is example for living or non-living. Here we can see that here grow, breathe and move. Is it possible to grow plants? Seeds is converted into plants after some days. We can easily say that plants are growing. Is plants breathe? Yes. Of course, at the time of photosynthesis, plants start breathing. It intake carbon dioxide gas and breathe out oxygen gas at the time of photosynthesis only. Here plants also breathe. Then, is it possible? Plant is move. Movement takes place in plants? Yes. In plants, movements also take place. In the former, the roots are grown in inside the soil, or the branches are grown or moved. So we call that plants also move. At the daytime, sunflower. You can see the sunflower plants are moving towards the sun. By this concept, we can say that plants also move. We can easily identify that plants are the example for living components. Plants are the example for living components. Next is one. Is one is example for living and not living? Yes, here the word one. Is it possible to grow one? No, the one is at the rest position. In similar way, is it possible to breed the one? No, it is also wrong. Here, one moves from one place to another? No. By using these definitions, we can easily say that one is example for non-living things. Okay. Next is human. Here, I take two examples, human and vehicle. Here we can say that humans are moved from one place to another place. Vehicles are also used for movement or go from one place to another place. Here, movement takes place in both human and vehicles. Humans are living or non-living? Vehicles. See here, human beings are breathe oxygen gas and breathe out the carbon dioxide gas. In similar way, vehicle can't breathe. In similar way, humans grow from baby to the human being. Human beings grow. But vehicles, is it possible to grow? No. Then we conclude that human beings are example for living components. In the same way, vehicles are example for non-living components. Okay. I give another example. Here I take seed. Seed is example for living or non-living. Okay. Seed is start sprouted, then it converted into plant after some days. We say that seeds are the living components. Okay, we are using raw seeds. Raw seeds. For soil. Then fried seed. Farmers use raw seeds to sow. Why farmers not use fried seeds to sow? What is the difference? Okay, raw seeds have living components. The seeds are start sprouted and then it starts growing into plants. We can say that raw seeds are examples for living components. Raw seeds are examples for living components. In similar way, why we are not using fried seeds to sow? Yes, because when we are going to fried seeds, the living character of the seeds become destroyed. So, we can't as fried seeds are examples for non-living things. Fried seeds are example for non-living things. By using these living and non-living things, we can easily say that the living component starts grow, breathe and move, and non-living components cannot move, grow and breathe. Here, such examples are very confusing. When we are using those examples, we are confused to identify that is it possible to say it is living or non-living? Yes, it is also possible. Because we are going to observe the characteristics of living and non-living beings, on the basis of the character, we can easily identify either the component is living or non-living. Here, by using living and non-living components, we can easily clarify the definition of environment again. Environment means of living and non-living organism existed in our surroundings. We call as environment whatever the things we can see in our environment, either it is living or either it is non-living. By these combination of living and non-living things, we call as environment. Here we can see that living and non-living organisms existed in our surroundings, we call as environment. Okay, let us move the characteristics of living organisms. Characteristics of living organism. What is the use of these characteristics of living organisms for us? Yes, the characteristics of living organisms help us to identify the given object that things are living or non-living. We can easily identify by using these characters. The first character is, it is one of the important questions. Note down the point. Living beings made up of cells. Living beings move. Living beings eat food. Living beings respire. Living beings reproduce. Living beings excrete. These are the characteristics of living organisms. These characters help to identify the things are living or non-living. For example, I will give some examples. You can identify that either it is living or non-living. Here, animal, then chair, then plant, insect, drumstick, vehicle. Yes, identify the given examples are living or non-living. If insect is living or non-living? Yes, see here, insect move, insect eat food, insect respire, insect reproduce. Here the four characters are similar to the characteristics of insect. We can easily identify that insect is the living component. Insect is a living component. Next, animal. See here, animals also move from one place to another place. Here, animals eat food, animals respire, animals reproduce. So, by considering these characteristics, we can say that animals also living organisms. Here is a chair. Chair means chair is move with the help of human beings or with the help of any force. By itself it can't move. So it's not correct. Is chair eat food? No, it is wrong. Is chair respire? No. Here, chair reproduce another chair? No. Here, no one character is matched to the characteristics of chair. So we call that chair is example for non-living component. Here, plant. We already know the example while we learning living component. Plant is example for living component. Here, groundnut seed. Whatever the seed we collect in the raw form, we call that living component. So groundnut seed also, groundnut seed also example for living component. Here vehicles. Vehicles move from one place to another place, but it can't eat food. Sometimes vehicles eat food in the form of petrol diesel, but it can't respire. Is it correct? In vehicle case, we can see that the only two characters are matched to the characteristics of vehicle, but the remaining characters is not matched. So we call as vehicle is one of the non-living organisms. Here, for the living organism, we must and should know that minimum four characters will be matched. So we call as living organism. Okay, dear students, today in this class we will learn about the meaning of environment, living and non-living components, characteristics of living organisms. In these characters, we will learn detail in